Hello everyone, I'm Dwayne and welcome to the channel. Today we're doing a quad cortex tone recreation video. So if you've never seen any of my other videos, essentially what I do is I take a song or a particular artist and I try and recreate that tone on the quad cortex. Now, I don't use anything paid, so I'm not using any IRs, I'm not using any of the paid Archetype plugins or anything like that, like Archetype Plenty or Gojira. This is all just pure models that are available on the quad cortex, no cloud captures or anything like that. So in this video, we're just going to kind of try and recreate the tone of a song, and the song today we're doing is The Hell Song by Sum 41. So I can already tell you, based on some research that I've already done, this isn't going to be a super complicated tone, because Sum 41 and Brown Sound, the guitarist, Sum 41, it's a pretty quintessential JCM800 sound, basically. It's not anything too over the top or fancy. So this video will probably be very quick, and as you'll see, it's kind of, it is, I guess, amp does play a big factor in sort of the tone for Sum 41 as well, and just a few little simple tweaks we can make it nice. So what we're going to do before we do anything else is we're going to put a noise gate on. Now the thing with the Sum 41 sound, it's not super high gain, so I've seen some people make the mistake of dialing the gain up too high. It's really kind of like the Metallica tone in that it's not super high gain. So we're going to put a JCM800 in there, which is the Brit 2203. For the cabinet, we're going to do the quintessential combination of the V30 cabinet. I like the Zilla custom V30 cabinet 412, but you could use pretty much whatever you want on there, and you probably get a similar tone. So this is what we get with the default settings, which I think are all at 5. Yep. As you can hear, that kind of that gets us there already, but we do need to make some tweaks on here, and I will use a Tube Screamer as well. I'm not sure if Brown Sound uses a Tube Screamer. So one thing I'm going to do is I'm going to wind back the gain quite low to 3, but then I'm going to put the bass up to 8. So turning the bass up is going to thicken the low end. It's going to add some weight to the power chords without making the tone too money, and it will kind of give our tone more of a full-bodied sound, which is really good for rhythm guitar. So that's what we want. For mids, I'm going to put them up slightly, just a moderate mid-range setting, kind of good for helping the guitar cut through the mix. And it obviously stops our tone from being too scooped, but we don't want it to be too bright. Now we're going to dial the treble back to 4. It's going to smooth out some of the highs and make sure the tone doesn't, you know, become too harsh or shrill, especially if you're kind of playing really hard. So before we change any of these other settings, this is what we have now. It's like the AC/DC Metallica, you know, logo. Sounds really nice. Okay, now for the presence, we're going to scoop that down now. I can hear that we want it a little bit lower because we don't want any of those piercing highs, which don't sound nice. Could go extreme and also drop the presence out completely, but I won't be doing that. Yeah, that sounds really good. I really like where this is going. Now we're going to dial up the master. And that should get us really close, I believe. But we're not done yet. So because we have dropped the gain down so much, now I'm going to EQ it using the Tube Screamer. I'm going to set the drive. I'm not going to set it to zero. I'm going to set it to 1.5, like very low. We may even drop that down to one. Because we're not using this to add extra gain. We're just pushing the amp a little bit more for clarity and tightness, basically. I will put the tone up. I don't usually touch the tone, but I will today. Just to brighten it up a little bit and compensate for the lowered treble and presence on the amp. And kind of gives us a little bit more clarity in the top end. Now for the level, we don't want to push this super high. So I'm going to start off something conservative like 6.5. Going to boost the signal hitting the amp. And tighten up the low end and push the amp for a little bit of grit, but without adding extra distortion. So now if we listen to this, we should have something a little bit closer. You can hear maybe you might want to put a low high cut on there as well. But now what we're going to do is I'm going to compare this to the original song and kind of see where we land on the song and tone. I'm just kind of based on going off memory for the moment, but I definitely think we're getting close. I think that sounds really good. We're definitely getting in the vicinity. So I can hear some tweaks that we need to make here. Firstly, I think the gain needs to come up to 4. I think 3 may have been too low. And I'm also going to bump up the bass a little bit as well. I might put that at 8.5. Okay, yeah, that's given us some Metallica now. As the frame of reference for this tone is kind of, it's a Metallica-esque tone, obviously, without scooping the mids in there. Now, I'm also thinking, I'm just thinking left field here. I wonder if putting a compressor in there could also, give us a little bit more kind of oomph when we're playing, kind of even out the dynamics and the sustain. Now, Brandsound isn't using a compressor, but I think we should give this a try and just kind of, let's just see kind of where we land. Now, I might use, what compressor am I going to use? Now, I may even just pull this out because it may not be needed. But the threshold, we're going to put that at negative 20. We'll keep the ratio at 4, actually. Now, attack, we'll put that at 30. Slightly slower attack. Kind of allow some of that initial pick attack to come through. And make sure the compressor doesn't, like, you know, make things too soft, basically. Now, we're going to drop that release quite a lot. And a moderate release will keep the compression subtle, but, you know, effective in our tone. Ensuring that, you know, our sustain is enhanced in there. So we may not need this, but I kind of had this sort of, like, it could really elevate it. And it could be good for leads and solos too. If You can hear this is without the compressor. No, we'll keep the makeup at 8. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to keep that compressor in for the moment. And kind of see where we land on that in comparison to the song. And you don't actually need the compressor in there, worth pointing out. This tone, I'm overcomplicating it here, but I feel like a compressor is just kind of good, especially maybe if your playing isn't as hard as well. It kind of compensates for softer playing. So if you're not a super strong rhythm guitarist, it's really going to kind of help you out there. But you could get rid of that and it would still be fine. So now that we've got that setting kind of set up, let's play along. Yeah, so you can hear that it's definitely there. I think that's definitely the tone that we're kind of chasing on there. Now, as I said, we may have overcomplicated it a little bit by putting the compressor in there. You don't actually need that in there, but I do definitely think that the compressor helps kind of even out the playing as well. So if you're not a tight rhythm player, it's like a little cheat code, I guess. I think that sounds great. Now, one thing that we can do to kind of make this sound a little bit like tighter is we can add in a low high cut, and we'll probably set that around about 80. And then for the low frequency, around the 11.5 mark. Yeah, that sounds really good to me. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue. We're not going to do a full playthrough now because we've done kind of the beginning a couple of times, but we're going to kind of start where we finished off, where I paused it last time, and play along. And you can just kind of hear that the tone works, and then that's pretty much it. Pictures running through my mind. We'll be right back. there you have it. That is the tone for Sum 41, the Hell song, but it is essentially like a pop punk tone when you really think about it. Not super game, but yeah, still quite effective. It's a really good rhythm preset, because I think that's a mistake people make with rhythm tones, is they think a lot of rhythm tones are high gain, when really, surprisingly, they're not. The gain isn't as much as you think, especially if you're a player like John Brown from Monuments. Like, he plays with similar gain settings, and he's playing, you know, progressive metal djent style music, but his picking is so hard that he's driving the amp with his hands in a way. This is kind of a little bit different, but same premise in that you just don't turn the gain up. You know, keep the gain low. You never go past halfway, basically, for this type of thing. You could dial it up a little bit more, but I would stay around the 4 mark, I think. At least for the Quad Cortex, anyway. Maybe the real JCM800 is probably a little bit different, but... You can hear we've got that clarity in there still. There you have it. I'll save this and upload it to the cloud and then link it in the description below. But yeah, let me know what you think. And if you download this and play with it yourself, let me know how it goes for you, if you had to make any tweaks, or if you think that I had to, you know, I missed something obvious in there. But I feel like, to my ears, especially comparing it to a final mix, you know, that's one of those things where you'll never get it 100% because you're not actually hearing the real guitar tone in that mix. So yeah, it's definitely one of those things where you're kind of trying to make mix replica of a guitar tone, but it's being double tracked. Other production stuff has been done over the top. And you'd be surprised if you listen to a lot of guitar, isolated guitar tracks from your favorite artists, they sound nothing like the final mix, because production and then bass and then all that other stuff that goes on the top. But it's just, it's a bit of fun, isn't it? So, okay, I'm going to save this and upload it, link it. But that's the end of this video. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll hopefully see you in the next one.